Hello, this is Sandeep. I'm from Edureka, the tutor for SQL Server and MSBI. Before starting, I just wanted to confirm, like, if someone cannot hear my voice, right, just can you ping me in the chat so that I'll be knowing that. Okay. So far, I don't see any thing. Okay, I got a message that it is very loud and clear. Thanks for that. It's from Lokesh. Thank you, Lokesh, for that. Okay, so let me start the course here. So here we'll be dealing a course called SQL Server and MSBI, right? So in this SQL Server and MSBI, we will be learning so many things. But before starting anything there, right? So I just wanted to give my brief introduction about myself and something about Edureka, right? So my name is Sandeep. I'm working on SQL Server and MSBA and other BA technologies from last 10 years, okay? I started my career in one of the telecom companies, and I worked in a reinsurance company, banking industry, and medical devices industry. So I was working with so many clients and implementing SQL Server and BA solutions for those clients. Okay, so currently I'm located in Singapore, and I'm working for a US-based company from Singapore. So I'm here in Singapore from last 5 years. So, and something about my professional career, right? So I've traveled all over the world in most of the places. Like I traveled all over the 10 Asian countries, US, Europe, and all those countries. So I have a better experience in managing the clients and better experience technically. So, and most important thing, like SQL Server and MSBI is a very, very favorite thing for me. So that's why I love to learn MSBI and teach MSBI, right? So this is something about my technical profile, right? So something about Edureka. Edureka is a place where we give online training. So this is one of the India's largest companies for online training, right? So here we have the different techniques, like the learning management platform, where we have the all the videos stored online for you to support for 24/7, right? So I'm just trying, I'll show you something on the screen, right? So this is something about Edureka. So you have joined through the GoTo meeting link, and what we'll do is we are recording this session for the future purpose, so that you can hear it again and again, and we support you in several different ways. So one of the ways is, like, we give the live online class training, and we have a learning management system where the information is stored on the cloud, and you can have the access to it at any point of time. So when I said at any point of time, it's 24/7 support. So we have the dedicated admin staff who can support you technically, as well as anything related to the subject, or 24/7, right? So the beauty of this thing, beauty of this class, right? We have framed the modules in such a way that you guys should be having something attention, so that what we did is, like, we added some quiz to every topic so that the candidates are alert and gain more knowledge and transform into a new different shape, right? So what we'll do is, like, at the end of this course we will have a project work where you learn to do the different things in MSBI, and at the same time we give a verifiable certificate where you can show that to the required in the required places, right? So this is something about the Edureka, right? So what we'll do is, before starting anything on MSBI, right? So one key thing I want to highlight is, I think because I see there are a lot of people, over 40 over people. 30 over people attending the class. So the one of the prerequisites to learn MSBI will be the SQL. So hope you guys have a little knowledge about the SQL, So at least the basics of the SQL. So once you know that, like I'm telling you, it's going to be very easy to learn MS BI. And the job trend and the job market for this is very good outside, right? I'll show you some trends and all those things at the end of the class. But this is something you'll have to learn, and it will be very easy to learn, and at the same time the opportunities are very, very strong compared to the other BA technologies in the market, right? So okay, so what I'll do is, and another thing what I want to tell you is, as we have so many candidates in the session, it's very tough to take all the questions at the same time. So what we did is, like, we have muted all the candidates right now. So what you can do is, if you can, there will be a chat window to raise a question to me. What I'll do is, in the regular interval, so I'll check out that chat window to see your questions and answer those particular questions. Okay. So just be aware of this this part. So this is something I have to tell you before starting the class. Okay. Okay. So before doing anything on MSB, right? So what I'll do is, like, we will set some objectives because this is the live webinar. So at the end of the day, I want all you guys to learn something, right? So if you cannot, if you don't learn anything from here, it's not at all possible. So I'm sure that you'll learn something from here, and you'll see the different advantages, different changes in the MSBI technologies and the opportunities, all, and so many things. So this webinar is mostly on theoretical part, and mostly concentrating on learning the high level overview of MSBI, and at the same time we will give you some short demo at the end of the class, so that you know at least, like, how the MSBI part looks like, right? So whatever you are seeing on the screen are the objectives for us. So what we'll do is, like, first of all, we'll try to understand the concept of BI. Okay, so what is BI? So some of you might be knowing what is SQL, right? So when you know SQL, so BI is a new a new domain in the market where Microsoft is there from last 9 to 10 years. Right. So when I say it's 9 to 10 years, actually it's new, because the databases and all those things actually came up in the 80s and 90s. But the concept of BI came only after 2000. Right. So it's a new for the software, but in the Microsoft Business Intelligence, the concepts which are growing and emerging day by day are enormous. Right. So we'll try to learn what is BI and what are the existing solutions currently in the market for the business intelligence, right? And we'll try to learn MSBI as a solution, and we'll do a high level architecture. We'll go through a high level architecture of MSBI, and we'll go through some concepts of MSBI and the tools under that MSBI. So there are three main tools in MSBI, which is, one is SSIS, second is SSIS, and third is SSRS. Okay. So, and what we'll do is, we'll do a comparison. We'll do a comparison with MSBI and other BA tools, and see where MSBI stands and why people are going for MSBI, right? And at the end of the day, we'll do a hands-on demo with some sample. Okay. So, and what I'll do is, like, as I told you earlier, so you may raise the questions. You try to type it in the chat window and send to me. What I'll do is, at the regular intervals, I'll look into it and answer that questions. Okay. So these are our objectives for this particular webinar. Okay. So one thing which we want to learn is, like, first of all, we wanted to learn the concept of business intelligence, right? So what is business intelligence? But before going to the business intelligence, how business intelligence has evolved in the market? Okay, suppose, let's say, I think most of you know the insurance companies or banking companies, right? So there is a lot of competition. Example, let's take an example of insurance company. There's a lot of competition in the insurance industry, So at least there are 20 to 25 companies who are offering the insurance policies to the customers. And at the same time, like the customer also has lot of options to go to any insurance company, right? So this is very, very problematic scenario for insurance company. So usually the insurance companies are banking or it may be a medical devices company, or so there is a lot of competition, right? So what the users, like the users have the different questions and different patterns to recognize, right? So one of the things in my experience, like all over, when I visited so many countries, like I've traveled all over Asia and Western parts, right? So when I go to the clients, one of the important thing they say is we have this information. So can you do a report or can you generate something for us, so that we can take some decision, or it will be useful in our daily life to decrease some manual work. So these kind of questions they will ask. So like if you see this power screenshot, right? So sometimes like I can't get the data I need. I have the data, but I can't get the data I need. I need some expert to get the required data. So I have A, B, C, D, E data, but I don't understand the whole information as together, right? I understand it is A, B, C different things, but as a together I don't understand. So I can't use this data, the data is too much for me. So there are a lot of concepts in the data is present for the users. So users have several questions, right? So what users want is, the data should be completely integrated across the systems, right? So when I say systems, you may be having one system which is giving only information about the sales. You may be having another system which is giving the information about the marketing events. You may be having another system which is giving the information about your daily transactions. So the data is sitting everywhere. Right, data is sitting everywhere, but we don't have a consolidated place where the users can take a better decision. Example, when we were talking about the concept of insurance has lot of competition, but which insurance company wins, which insurance company will get lot of profits? The company who takes the better decisions, right? So who can take the better decisions? The people who have a better understanding of their data. So how can they do that? They can do with the concepts of BI, right? So this is something of the BI. So I'm trying to take you from the real world business scenario into something into the technical land, right? So this is something users want. The data should be completely integrated across the systems, and I want the summary, right? Example, if you take the cricket, everybody knows Sachin Tendulkar, right? Sachin Tendulkar, like, he has played so many of matches. But if you look at the Star Cricket or Ten Cricket, what they do is, whenever Sachin Tendulkar used to come out to the batting, they will give a scorecard, right? This is the number of matches, and these are the number of sixes, number of centuries, number of test centuries, and this is everything is summarized for you so that you can quickly know what is happening. So that is the meaning of summary. So users also, at the same time, when you're viewing the cricket, you expect the summary of the data. When a bowler comes, you want these profiles. So everything is summarized, right, for you. So those things, the users also will expect in the offices, right, in the companies to run the business, right? So sometimes, like, they want the historical data. Sometimes, like, if you are watching cricket, then you want to know how much Sachin Tendulkar was, how many sixers number Sachin Tendulkar hit in 2010 or in 2008. So how many number of centuries he made before 2005. So these kind of things, actually, we are, as viewers of the cricket, so we are excited about that, right? So to run the business, to run the organization, so the sales managers or the vice presidents or the presidents are very eager to improve the bottom line, which is profit, right? So profit is an important thing for any company. Without profit, no company can run, right? So they want to track the different historical data, and sometimes they want some what if capabilities. What do you mean by what if capability? So what happens if I take this decision? Am I going to enter the losses or will I get some profits? So these kind of things, right? So luckily, we have a solution for that. So there are a lot of BI tools in the market, So one of the BI tools which we have a solution is MSBI, right? For all these questions, like there is a lot of competition, that we have to take the better decision and all those things for all these questions. So we will have the BI as the solution, right? So I already see the people have raised some questions here, but what I'll do is I'll group those questions after some module, and I'll try to reply that back, right? Okay, thank you. So for all these problems we have a solution called BI, right? So but at the same time, like the BI is like looks like a technical terminology. So but what is exactly the BI? Business intelligence, right? But what is business intelligence, right? So there is no standard definition for business intelligence, to be frank, right? And business intelligence is not owned by anyone, right? Business intelligence is not a tool, okay? So business intelligence is not owned by any company. Business intelligence is not a patented thing which some company has done. So business intelligence is a concept. Business intelligence is a domain. You might have heard about some domains like data warehousing, ERP systems, CRM systems, programming languages, right? So like this, business intelligence has also evolved as a domain. It itself is a concept. Okay? So anybody can do the BI. You can do the BI and I can do the BI, or anybody can do the BI, right? So there is no standard definition, but just to explain you clearly, right? So it's what is business intelligence? Like, we have some problems. What we want to do is we want to transform those problems into some information or knowledge using some techniques, so that we have enable the users to take the best decisions, right? Insurance company having lot of competitions, but what BI will help them is it will transform the existing data in their companies into a better shape, so that one of the sales manager or a vice president in insurance company can take a decision on a new policy, roll out of a new policy, or make changes to the existing policy. At the end of the day, what happens? Once they take the decision, they will get the profits. So once they get the profits, the company will be boosting and all the revenues will be going up. So this is how the business intelligence helps the company. So when I was working in telecom industries or banking and insurance industries, like usually they ask the different kinds of the questions usually are very, very random. They just come and know, hey guys, I want this report within 2 days. So how can you do that? So these kind of things, because like the market, because of the competition in the market, so the demands in the BI are enormous. So this is something called as business intelligence, right? What we'll do is this converting the business related data into some better decision. Okay, so this, just keeping in mind that, like, to get the better decision and fact based decision, we use some BI tools, right? Okay, so how theoretically I was saying that the business intelligence is used to make a fact based decision, but how can it happen? So how can it happen? It cannot happen just like that, right? So let's take the same example, the insurance company. One of the insurance companies say it is not running properly, but just take another insurance company which is running with heavy profits. So what the company which is not running with profits, what they will do is, like, they'll try to identify what are the problems. What are the existing problems? Are our insurance policies much expensive, or is it not covering much risk, or is it the sum assured are very less, or what is going wrong, or our salesperson not doing good, what's going wrong? So what, identify the problems and identify the market opportunities, right? So once they have the business identification problems and market opportunities, they can see that, okay, I want this data in this format so that I can take a better decision. So what they'll do is they identify the problem, and then what they do is they get the required data. And they'll see, explore alternatives. Like, once they get the data, they'll see that whether they can do the things with this data or they have any other alternative. And they'll do the data analysis once they get the reports, and they'll take a business decision. Okay? But where we are involved in this, as MSBI developers or administrators or architects, in those, all those, there are different roles, right? So where are we involved? So identify problems or opportunities. We are not involved here. The business users are involved. So gather required data. So the developers will be involved. Explore alternatives. So we are not involved. The business will be involved here. Data analysis, business will be involved. Business decision, business is involved. So it means that business intelligence is more about the business. Business intelligence is about the more about the business people or clients or users to improve the business. But what we will do, our role is to enable a platform for them to take a better decision. Right? So as a developer or architect or admin, so what we do is we enable a BA platform for them so that they tap on the data or some reports and they take a better decision. So this is something, something the roles and responsibilities of a developer or an architect and a business user. Right? So if you see the roles and responsibilities, it is more on the business side. Okay? And we, for us, it, we are enabling the platform. Okay, so you might have heard some of the BA solutions in the market. So what kind of BA solutions have you heard? So we heard so many, I heard so many BA solutions, but what I did is like I tried to keep only few of those things here, right? So, so there are some large BA vendors. Example, if you take IBM, IBM has a BA solution. So what is their BA solution? They say that use the database called DB2. And use their ETL tool called DataStage and use Cognos as a reporting tool. That's their BA solution. And SAP has a BA solution called SAP BI. Right? And Oracle also has OBIW and their Oracle database as a BA solution. And MicroStrategy has a reporting platform as a BA solution. Right? That, so we have something else called something like business objects also. Right? So at the same time, if you see here Microsoft, Microsoft is a very, very key player in the business intelligence and databases now in the market. So they have grown strongly right from 2005. Before 2005, Microsoft was not much into the BI, but after 2005, it has evolved into a competition where IBM and Oracle are getting a tough, tough competition from Microsoft. Right? So there are some new vendors. Somebody like Pentaho or Jaspersoft and ClickView, Tableau. So these are mainly on the presentation tools and other concepts, right? So this is something on the existing solutions. So different people will learn different BA solutions. But why we need to come to the MSBI? Why the companies need to go to the MSBI is a big question, right? It's a big question for everyone, right? So we will see how, why the companies are going only for MSBI but not for the other tools. Okay, so what happens is like, so these are the, some questions of the manager. But before jumping here, right, so what we'll do is, I'll try to go to the questions tab and I'll see if there are any questions raised. Okay, so, okay, so Himanshu has raised a question, right? So probably Hadoop and machine learning is also the probable solution of these problems. Okay, so this machine learning and Hadoop is the next level to the BI. So BI is something above the databases. So previously we used to have something like flat files, right, in the old generations. So we used to use flat files and we came to the Excel spreadsheets and we came to the Access databases. And then we came to databases, which are RDBMS. And then the next level, we have the BI. And on top of BI, one of the components of BI is data mining. And now there is a big trend on the big data, right? So which has Hadoop, machine learning, R analytics, and all those things. So this is the, those things are more onto the data scientist side, but not a particular BI platform. So it, BA platform will give something to take the immediate decisions or some in the form of reports or pictorial representation, right? So I hope this answers the questions, right? So somebody asked like, what is the duration of the webinar? Duration of the webinar actually is, it takes around 1 hour to complete, and I may be completing in 10 minutes extra, right? So. Okay, so somebody asked, Lokesh asked, like, what are the advantages of MSBI over other BI tools? That's a very good question and important question. So what I'll do is after a couple of slides, we have very, very good slides where we show what the comparison between the MS BI and other BI tools, and we see that why companies are going only for MS BI but not for the other tools, right? So these are the questions I answered. So don't worry, the people have asked questions, but what I'll do is take a break and then come back and see that. But one important question, Dev has asked one question. What are the prerequisites to learn MS BI? Very important question, right? So please remember, the prerequisites to learn MS BI is basics of SQL. If you don't know SQL, please, please learn SQL. Without knowing SQL, you cannot do anything in MS BI. Right? So I'm not talking about the expert level in the SQL Server, but at least you should be knowing the queries. That's a minimum expectation for MS BI. Okay? So that's a good question, and it's very important. Everybody should be very, very clear about this. Okay? Okay. So what I'll do is I'm just skipping the questions part, and I'll come back here again. Okay. So for all these business problems, right? So we have the different business problems. So one of the solution we say it is MS BI. So why it is MS BI? So other BI vendors also give the solutions, right? So why MS BI is the only solution? So using MS BI, what we can do is we can build a data warehouse. So where it shows a single version of truth, okay? We can eliminate the different gut feeling decisions, right? So what is the meaning of these gut feeling decisions? It is nothing but for some of the business problems, there may be some multiple options available. So using some fact-based data, maybe we can have a better decision, right? So we can get a timely and quick answers to the business problems, right? And what it does is, like, if you do these decisions offline in a paper without using any software, so there are heavy chances that it may go wrong, because you are depending on a human being, right? So if the human being is doing something, then it may definitely go wrong, right? So we cannot believe that. And the main reason of MS BI, why it is a solution, is the beautiful thing of MS BI is Microsoft gives a database as a product, and Microsoft gives ETL as a product. So what is the ETL? ETL is something which is used to get the different kinds of data into a single place. Okay, we'll know more about the ETL later. And Microsoft gives a place where you can have the beautiful reports and stored in SharePoint and Power BI. And Microsoft gives a place where users can log in and see the reports in a web browser. So there is superb concept involving in MS BI, which some of the companies are not able to give. So why they are not able to give, I'll tell you in the future slides. And we have the support for the historical data using the different concepts, and support for the summarized data thus identifying the business problem solutions, right? Okay, so this is something like MSDN. So before going anywhere, right? So what I'll do is, like, what I'm doing is here is the slide where it shows that for Microsoft strongly supports social networking, especially in the technical world. So for that, what they did is, like, they have developed a framework called MSDN, so which is called Microsoft Digital Network. So in the MSDN, right, so they have different forums, blogs, you can have the networking with the different people, you can ask questions, you can get the material, downloads. There's a lot of thing going in the TechNet. Okay, so if you go to the technet.microsoft.com or msdn.com, you get a lot of information there. So there is so much of information on the MS BI. So I may be not telling some of the information about the MS BI, but you can find it in the MSDN or technet.microsoft.com. Right. Okay. So before jumping into the MS BI, let me see if there are any questions. Okay. So Himanshu was asking a question, like, can MS BI be integrated with existing SQL Server DB or MySQL DB to fetch more useful reports from the existing DB. Yes, MSBI has that capability. Not only these databases, MSBI has a tool called SSIS, which can take the sources from the different sources, right from XML data, flat files, Excel files, CSV files, different kinds of databases, systems, and all those things can get. It's a very, very complex tool where it can get the variety of the data. So somebody asked, is MSBN, MSDN freely accessible? Yes, it is. Like MSDN is not a content, but it is a it's a digital network by Microsoft where they put lot of code samples, where they put lot of forums, blog, questions, answers, all those things. It's a free you can create a Microsoft Live ID and you can access anything from there. Okay, somebody asked, like Aladdin asked, is MSBI compatible with Oracle databases? Yes, MSBI is compatible with the Oracle database. So when I say it is compatible, if you have something in already stored in Oracle, can you use MSBI as a solution to point to the Oracle to generate some data and some reports out of it? Yes, definitely possible. Right. Okay. So these are the questions asked by the user. So I'm coming back to the MSBI architecture. Okay. So till now we have learned something on the BI. And we saw that why people are going for the BI, but we will see like what is the architecture of MSBI. Okay. So by when you go to the MSBI, just remember three areas. So it's very, very important, and we are going to cover those three areas in this class. I mean in this course. Okay. So those three areas, one of the areas is SSIS. Okay. This is called as SQL Server Integration Services. So what this SQL Server Integration does, okay? SQL Server Integration is nothing but your data may be anywhere. Example, your data may be in SAP, your data may be in Oracle, your data may be in a flat file, your data may be in a CSV file, your data may be in Excel sheet, your data may be in ERP system, CRM system, your data may be in SharePoint. Your data may be in different kinds of format. So what SQL Server Integration will do, it will do a process of ETL. Okay, it will do a process of ETL. Very, very important concept, ETL. Right? ETL is nothing but extract, transform and load. You have a source of data, you extract it, you transform into your required format. Into your required format and load into one database. Load into a database. So yours in ETL, your source can be any variety or your target can be any variety. There is no specific reason that your source is this one and your target is no, nothing like that. Your source can be Oracle, your target can be DB2. Your source can be Microsoft SQL Server, your target can be flat file. Right? It can be anything. So there is no restriction on that. Okay. So this is the main purpose of SQL Server Integration Services. So by the name itself says as integration. So what do you mean by integration? Integration means that integrating the data from the different places and putting it into one place. That's it. So just remember that terminology, right? So these are the different data sources and we put that into a data warehouse. So what is a data warehouse? Data warehouse is it different than the database? No. Data warehouse is not different than a database. Data warehouse is a concept, okay? But the physical storage of the data will be in the database itself, okay? But the kind of format, the kind of table structures, the kind of linkage we have in the database will be different than the normal OLTP structure, okay? So we will have the data in the form of in the form where it can support online analytical processing. Very, very, very big word, buzzword in the market. If you know this OLAP, I'm sure that within 1 or 2 months you can get a job if you are looking for an opportunity in MSBI. It's very, very important concept in MSBI. Right? Very important, very critical, very few people in the market who knows the complete concept of OLAP. Okay, we'll see what is OLAP. How it is used and all those things in the later part of the section. But Once this integration is done using a tool called SSIS, what we'll do is we will prepare a thing called cube. Okay, you might have heard about a cube in your childhood. I mean, when you learn mathematics in the childhood, we always learn one-dimensional, two-dimensional things in the geometry, right? If you take a square, square is nothing but it has a length and breadth, right? It has a side and side, right? So if you take a rectangle, it has a length and breadth, right? At the same time, when you go to the concept of cube, if cube is something like you have length, breadth, and width, three things, right? So if you are talking about a rectangle, it's a two-dimensional thing, but when you are talking about a cube or cuboid, then it becomes a three-dimensional thing. So something like x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. If you can remember something from your geometry in the mathematics, but if you cannot, that's okay. We'll learn what is cube. If you see this picture, right? If you see this picture, this is something is looking like a cube, right? So this is a multi-dimensional structure. So if you see that cube from one angle, you cannot see the backside angle of the cube, right? So if you see the backside angle, you cannot see the front side angle. But the information is in the multidimensional. So it has a three axis, x axis, y axis, and z axis. But what are those axes? How it is used for us? And all those things is again a different concept. We will see. Okay, but to develop that concept of cube, we have something very important tool called analysis services, which is short form called as SSIS. Very important, SQL Server Analysis Services. And then once you have the cube, basically you have want something as a report, right? So to generate the reports in the Excel or in the SharePoint, then you need something to generate a report. Report is very easy. Report is not something that you don't see anywhere, right? Report is something you see everywhere. Example, you pay LIC premium, you get a printout from the system, right? It's a report. What it says, it's a policy number, your name, your premium amount, your sum assured, and your date of payment, all those things in a very neat manner. You get your telecom bill, you get your electricity bill, you get your water charges, right? You get your internet bill. So everything is in the form of a report, right? But some of the reports can be kind of very list reports, what we see in the electricity bill and all. But some reports can be very attractive. If you see ESPN and Star Sports, when you're watching cricket, they give beautiful graphs about a player, right? If you're watching a football game, they give beautiful graphs and scorecards, how much was the country at the time of 35th over, and how this is country doing at this 35th over, how is the bar graphs and all those. So all those concepts come under reports. So we have a very good tool called SSRS, which is part of the MSBA, SQL Server Reporting Services. Okay. So these three tools will be part of MSBA. So the only reason I spent some time in this slide is these are the very important concepts, and this is something you are going to learn in this course, right? So remember three things, SSIS, SSIS and SSRS, okay? We will see the concepts of it, but this is the concept, okay? You have the data in the different places. We use ETL as SSIS as a ETL tool. We use SSIS as to build a cube, and we generate reports out of it, okay? Okay, now it's the time for real-time example. Good. So I think most of you might have heard about a brand called Mango. Right. So Mango is a retail outlet where they store the different multi-brand, multi-item retail brand. Right. So the primary business for them is the most popular brands in the casuals or jeans and trousers and all those things. Right. So let's take the example of Mango. So if you see this picture, right, they are selling a lot of apparels and accessories here, right? So this Mango store is located in on different parts of the world, okay? So say located one of the Mango stores is located in 4 parts of India or in 10 parts of US and a couple of parts in Singapore and 5 parts in Middle East and Europe, right? So this is covering the world. So the scenario is something like this. If you read out these sentences, right, so every outlet stores their customer data in their respective data, and it's not mandatory that every outlet is using the same database, right? So somebody who is running a Mango store in India may be using some database or some flat file or some Excel sheet to maintain the information about their sales. But somebody sitting in the US where the lot of sales are happening, they may be running their business in the Oracle database or SQL Server database or maybe in the SAP, you don't know. It depends on the business, type of business, right? So it is not mandatory that everybody should go in the same platform. So it may, there is a variety of data, right? So somebody use Oracle, SAP, somebody use flat files, Excel file, right? So how SSIS can solve this problem? What SSIS can do is SSIS have the different capability, like it can take the extract data from different sources and it can load into a database, right? That is what SSIS can do, okay? And once SSIS does the integration from the different variety of sources, what SSIS, which is the analytics services tool, can do is it can develop a cube. What is the concept of cube? Okay, so the concept of cube is it is used for multi-dimensional analysis. So very simple example, if somebody is watching the sports or especially the cricket and football, right? So example, let us take a famous player in cricket. Example, if you take the Indian captain Mahindra Singh Dhoni, right, in the cricket. So example, so you may want to ask the question, how many number of centuries did Mahindra Singh Dhoni made till now? This is one question. Okay, the other question is going deep into how many number of centuries Mahindra Singh Dhoni has made against Australia. This is second question. Third question is how many number of centuries did Mahindra Singh Dhoni made against Australia in Australia? And the fourth question is against Australia in India, right? And the fifth question is against Australia playing in India in the year 2005. So the questions are going deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper, and it has no end, right? If you see the pattern of the questions, it is different angle. First I ask first angle question, and then I have taken two scenarios, then three scenarios, four scenarios, five scenarios. So this is nothing but different dimensions I'm asking. So this is a multi-dimensional questions. So the answers for multi-dimensional questions will be available in a cube, right? But how it will be available, you will see when you learn the total MSBA course, okay? And then once you have the data there, then reporting is just to present that in a beautiful format, very, very beautiful format. So when the football player comes onto the ground, they show a chart like how many number of goals he was doing in the last World Cup, and what is his performance out of 100%. There's a beautiful dashboards and reports, right? So something to show to the end user, we use the reports, right? So what is our tool? We use a tool called SSRS to show the reports, right? So what we do is, like in this diagram, you're seeing that we can generate the reports from a cube, right? So, but the reports can be generated from anywhere. It can be generated from a table, or it can be generated from a flat file, or anywhere. It can be from a data warehouse or anywhere, right? So reports is something it can show. So what MangoStore does is it can integrate the data from the different sources, and it can form a cube, and it can generate a report. So why they have to do all these things? Example, the owner of the MangoStore, the CEO of the MangoStore, is sitting in the US. He wants to check how his company is doing all over the world. How this company is doing in Europe and Middle East, how his company is doing in Latin America, Asia Pacific, Japan, or anywhere, right? So the data is distributed in the different formats. It's very tough for one who is sitting in the US to read all the data present all over the world and see and take a particular decision. Right. So what it will do is, like, it will collect the data, it will put it in the form of a cube, and it will give all the answers to the CEO's question or all the answers to a senior executive in the Mango. So that what they do is, example, if they see that in the Europe and Middle East, if they see that their sales is going down, what they do is they take out some stores from there. And if they see in India, if the trend is going up, what they do is they put more stores in India. They see in which city the sale is high, the affordability levels is high, and they can establish the business in that way. So that is how they take the better decisions. Okay. Let me answer a couple of questions. I see some questions here, but I'll take out one or two from here. Okay, so somebody, Sanjay, asked that all the tools ETL, OLAP are parts of MSBI? Yes, ETL tool, OLAP tool and reporting tool are part of MSBI. We have SSIS for ETL, SSIS for OLAP and SSRS for reporting, right? So how performant, performance efficient it is, right? In real-time scenarios, very, very good question, right? So usually people think that when they come to the Microsoft, it's an issue of performance, but it's not. Microsoft has beaten a challenge for Oracle and has given a challenge to for Oracle, Cognos and IBM guys, saying that they have stored 1.4 TB of data in record time, right? In just few minutes, they have stored 1.4 TB of data into the target warehouse, where the other tools were not able to do it. So Microsoft has gone into the stage where it can do most of the things in a very, very efficient way. So being in the Microsoft platform myself from last 10 years, I see this is lot of change in the Microsoft technology. Before 2003, 2004, it was something different. But in 2014, Microsoft is in a stage, a very, very good stage in the market, right? So I'm jumping on to the next platform, next slide. So I told you we have three things, right? Just keep in mind that we have three things, SSIS, AS and RS, right? So usually you have a database, right? So this is something like, it gives a very clear picture of how the MSBA platform runs, right? This particular slide, if you see, different variety of sources, using integration services, we store into a database. And we use analysis services to generate a cube, and we use reporting services to show the report. Right? This is business intelligence platform. And once you have the report, the reports can be viewed in the Excel, or it can be viewed in the Performance Point Server, or it can be viewed in the Power BI. Right? And the final delivery will be the reports. It may be in a SharePoint server, or it may be in a Documentum or other any other content management software. Okay. So this is something about, again, about the database management and all those things. So Microsoft gives SQL Server database, SSIS, AS and RS as a single solution when you buy the license for that. Okay. So this is all the same concepts. Okay. So I think Himanshu or Sanjay or someone asked a question like, what is the comparison of MSBA with other tools and why the companies are going for MSBA, right? So I'll show you some slides where you'll be amazed seeing the statistics and the development the Microsoft is making in the field of business intelligence and databases. And you will see a situation where the other companies are feeling lot of heat from Microsoft. Microsoft has got a lot of money where they're investing in the BI platform, and they are not expecting much returns at this stage. They are expecting lot of business to come onto their platform and get the profits in the future. I'll show you some slides where you will feel that, oh man, Microsoft, how can they manage it with at this very, very low cost, and whereas other companies are giving very high. That's why in my experience, I was working with banks, insurance companies, telecom companies, medical devices, all the different companies, different industries, right, are now having the Microsoft BI and database solutions. Earlier it was not, but right now all the companies has. Example, I'll give you some example of people who are using effective MSBA, Bank of America, Barclays Capital, Citibank, Standard Chartered Bank, ANZ. If you take the insurance companies, most of the insurance companies, if you take the telecom company, Verizon, AT&T, British Telecom, all these companies, everybody has this MSBA as a platform. It's growing, and it's going to be a super duper BA platform in the future, right? Okay, so I'm showing you some slides. Example, if you take a base product. So what I mean by base product is nothing but a whatever they, whenever you buy the product, right, they give something to you. Right, so Microsoft gives database as a database, Microsoft SQL Server as a database solution, SSIS as a ETL solution, AS as a cubes or OLAP solution, and SSRS as the reporting solution. Okay, so for the base cost, it is a $25,000 USD, and Oracle is 40,000 and IBM is 25,000. They sell like this first. They sell like this, right? Again, when it comes to the concept of manageability, example, you want some tools to do the performance tuning to improve better, then what Oracle will say is, okay, there's no problem, just give me $3,000, I will give you a tool. You want to find some diagnostics or statistics of your database, you want to do some partitions to improve the performance, no problem, just give me $3,000 or $10,000, I'll give you some tools, right? And IBM also says like that, but Microsoft, no, already we have already given this. Business intelligence. If you see the business intelligence, right, for OLAP, Oracle is charging around 20K and mining 20K, B800 20K, 60K extra already, and this is also too much here. But Microsoft says that, no, you pay only for SQL Server and we give BA solution free. Still the cost is 25. High availability. What is high availability? Example, if you are having bank account, ICICIbank.com, or if you have Standard Chartered Bank.com, or if you have some other retail bank like Citibank.com, right? Just think that if those sites are down for 5 minutes, how many number of companies they get, right? If the companies are running the business on some particular database, then they should expect very, very high availability, right? If that is down, then the people will scream, right? So that's why you should have high availability in your applications, right? So if you see that for high availability, again, Oracle and IBM charges heavily. And most important thing, these are the only three players available in the market who are very, very competent in the BI. There are some other players. Example, if you take business options, we have SAP, of course, but SAP BI is a very, very expensive solution, and I cannot at least compare in this chart. It's very super duper expensive, right? But we have some other BI solution, example, business objects, but business objects is part of SAP again. We have something else like MicroStrategy, which is a reporting tool. We have a Tableau, ClickView or reporting tools, but they don't have the databases. Right? But these are the players who have the databases, ETL technologies and reporting technologies and OLAP technologies, everything, right? So if you want multi-core, if you want to run your process in the multi-core environment, then you have to still pay extra, right? So then if you see the total cost, right, if I'm a senior manager, example, my company, right, the company where I'm working, it's a medical device industry and it's a multinational company having doing billions of dollars of business. Professionally, when I'm running a project which is a SQL Server 2012 project, personally now in the current situation, so we sometimes evolve the different costs. So if something is not available, right, we see that how much is it in Oracle, how much is it in SQL Server, how much is it in IBM. Then example, the master data man, the most recent thing what we did is the master data management and data quality services. So the master data management, data quality services, there are some concepts which are available in the three different players. But what Microsoft is giving, they are giving the master data management, data quality service also in this cost. But what IBM, when we contacted IBM, right, they say that if you want to maintain the master data, okay, you can maintain. But what we do is we, for every record, we charge $2. But our company has millions of records. So how many dollars I should give to them? So we said that no, we are not going for IBM platform because it is costing over 100 billion for us. So which is not worth of it, right? So we are going for a solution called master data management, which is available in 2012 platform. And we are going for a solution called data quality services, which is also available here. So personally, actually I compared the different prices for the different things. Not only here in the ETL area, comparison between SSIS and Informatica. So in most of the cases, right, Microsoft is very, very, very affordable and company can easily grant the funds to get the license. That's why, right, if you see the job trend of MSBI is very high nowadays, right? So the total cost is 25,000 for Microsoft, including all these things. But if you go for other things, right, it is around 350,000 to 450,000, right? So it's very, very expensive. So unless the company has real money, or like if it's a super duper critical project where they say that no, even money is not a matter and all those things, still like they can go for SQL Server. But if the company, because of the reputation the Oracle has right from 90s, they may go for it, right? But the other most of the companies are going for SQL Server and MSBA solution for now. Very important slide. I think most of the people who are listening to the session may be interested in this, right? So what is this? It's a report. So what kind of report it is? It's a trend analysis report. So can we generate this in MSBI? Yes, we can do that. We have a solution called SSRS, reporting services, where we can do these type of trend analysis charts. So what information you are getting from here? Job trends for MSBI. Example, this orange color is MSBI, blue color is SAP. Like that, you have every color for different players, right? So if you see, right, from in 2006, 7, 8, 9, MSBI was nothing, right? It was just evolving here, right? So when I started working in MSBI platform in 2005, there were very, very, very few players in the market. And then it slowly evolved, and in 2010, 11, there are a lot of jobs created. If you see this orange portion, which is MSBI, right, there are a lot of jobs happening on MSBI, whereas other platforms, if you see the IBM BI, it is still there. Why it is still high? They have a very good tool called Cognos, okay? But nowadays, like, the Cognos is replaced by also the BI solutions. So that's why if you see, the Cognos is coming down and our MSBI is going up, up, up. So this is not our chart or something. This particular thing we have taken from indeed.com. Okay. It's a website, indeed.com. So in the indeed.com, you can get a trend analysis of these things. So we have taken there, and it is showing this last 3 years, it's very high, and it's going high according to my experience. Okay, so let me take some questions here. Okay, so one question like Piyush was asking is, how does the data extraction takes place from Oracle or SAP to do the analysis? Okay, so we have a tool called SSIS, which is called as SQL Server Integrated Services. What happens is it can data from variety of sources and it can pull place. So I'll show you, personally show you a demo where it can pull the data from different places and put into one single store, right? One person asked, like, is Informatica or one kind of BA solution? No, Informatica is not a BA solution. Informatica, but ETL, right? Extract, transform, and load. So Informatica is something like our SSIS. SSIS and Informatica are computers, okay? And Cognos is equal to SSIS plus SRS. And business objects is equal to SSIS plus SSRS, right? Informatica is not a BA solution. Informatica is just the ETL tool, okay? Right, so these are the list of questions I have. So I'm just going back to the things. So hope these questions clarifies to you. And what I'll do is I'll go through here. I'll show you a demo where you can see that how MSBI can do the extraction from the different places, okay? So one important thing is, like, where I want to tell everyone is, we will run this course, okay? So if what we'll do is we'll run this course in SQL Server 2014. So there's different versions of MSBI available now. So let me tell you something about the versions, okay? SQL, so MSBI started from 2005, okay? So before 2005, there were concepts of ETL in SQL Server, in Microsoft, but there were very, very old technologies. But the pure MSBI started from 2005, right? So 2005. Then and then the next version they released is 2008, in the year 2008. And the next version, very, very stable version with lot of features, something like MDM, all those things are available in 2008 R2, which is a release 2. And then they released a version called 2012 with powerful tools like data quality services in this, right? And high availability tools. And now recently we have an version which is SQL Server 2014. So in this course, right, what we'll be doing is we'll be learning SQL Server database. We will be using the SQL Server database as 2012. Okay. but we will learn MSBI in 2014. Okay, so this is MSBI is part of SQL Server 2014, right? So SQL Server, you have the option to install MSBI. So what we'll do is we are going to run the very latest version in the market. Okay, you're going to learn the 2014 version, which is very latest in the market. So what is advantage for you learning the latest things? So you get a chance to learn very new things where other players or where other developers in the market who are already working in the MNCs or companies on MSBI may not know. You will be knowing those concepts, right? So when you go to the interviews or when you get an opportunity, you will be standing a step forward from them, right? And when you learn the latest version, what is the advantage? You get to know the concepts of old things also, right? So but practically, once you learn the SQL Server MSBI 2014, you will be able to do something in 2008 or 2012 also. Okay. So what I want to show is there are some differences, some changes from 2008 to 2014. So example, so this is something, this is SSIS. I opened is a 2008 version of it. Okay. So I opened the 2008 R2 version of SSIS. So this is something SSIS. There are a lot of things in the SSIS. There are a lot of things in SSIS where you can study. But as this is a demo, I don't have a chance to tell you all those things. But what I'll be showing is, if you can see my screen, right? As I told you, I'm very enthusiastic in learning the different concepts of SQL Server and MSBI. And what I do is every time a new tool comes, right, I do the installation of it, try it and implement it in my local computer. If you see my local computer, I have all the versions of SQL Server and MSBI, right, from 2005, 2008, 2008 R2, 2012, 2014. So I have all the different things. So in everywhere, like, you have the different. So if I see the SQL Server 20, you have different ports of it later, right? So this is something how the MSBA looks like. So what we can do is we can, what I did is, like, as this is a webinar section, so the time is very limited for all the people. Already I think I have consumed already 1 hour 10 minutes, so I'm going to finish this in next 5 to 10 minutes. Please bear with me. So I'll show you a sample demo. Somebody asked me that how can MSBI fetch the data from the different sources and load into a single thing, right? So if you see, like, this is the 2008 version of the thing what I'm showing, but I'll show you the 2014 version also after this. Okay, so this is 2008 version. So if you see this, right, we have the different tool sets here which can pull the data from the different sources. So specifically we have a concept called data flow. Okay, so if I go to the data flow, right, so we have the different kinds of transformations. I can take that my source can be Excel source, flat file source, OLEDB source, raw file source, XML source. When I say OLEDB, it can be DB2, Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, Sybase, or any Red Bricks or anything, right? Any kind of database. So I can do the transformation of the data into variety of formats. And what I can do is I can load into the variety of targets. So what kind of targets I have? These are the targets I have in 2008 R2, right? So these are the different functionality, but what we'll go into the deep dive of all these things during the course, right? It's very well, but I'll show you is, like, this particular thing, it's a complex scenario which takes in. What this example will do is we have some Excel spreadsheets. Example, if you go to the AW data refresh and data, I have the different Excel spreadsheets which is having the data here. Okay, so what this is doing is this is taking the data from different Excel spreadsheets and loading into the called dimension tables and fact tables, which are part of the data warehouse. When I say dimension tables and fact tables, it is loading into the data warehouse. So here it is taking the data from those spreadsheets and CSV files and loading into the data warehouse. So how it is loading? It is using the concepts of MSBI. So this is a very complex solution you are going to see. you take this scenario, right, what it is doing the several steps here, right? It's a very, very complex scenario. It is taking the different data sources and all those things. Performance, it will wise, it will be efficient, it will do a parallel processing and all those things. And what it will do is it will finally go into the a place and it will store the data. So that is the target of this, like example, how it will take the sources and how it will be storing the data. We will open one of the things. Example, you open this. This is the source. This source is coming from CSV file, okay? And this is the target. This is target is nothing but the SQL Server destination. So out of this, whatever you are seeing here, you can see this transformation, sources and targets. So what I'll do is I'll, for the demo purpose, I'll try to load this package. What I'll do is just, this is the project. I'll do right click and execute project. Okay, execute SSIS package. We call it as a package, right? So once you execute this SSIS package, right, it will be a step-by-step process. Example, so when the task is happening, what it will do is it will be yellow color. It is something like the street lights. When you go into the street light, yellow color is the standby position, green is already come and go. And red is something like the error, right, which you have to stop. It is also something green, red, green and yellow. So if you see this package, right, it is executed now. Whatever you are seeing in the green, it means already it is successfully executed, right? So everything is executing. It's doing a very, very massive parallel processing now, right? Everything is doing, it's going, right? And finally, what it will do is it will load into a AdventureWorks data warehouse, right? So so once this process is completed, we can actually have the progress of it. It has started here and it has dropped the timetables and it is creating something. Everything is there. Once the package is completed, it will show a message called package execution completed successfully, right? So if you see this, everything will be green, right? This is successfully done. This is something which we are doing in the SSIS, right? So how you can track the progress of it? You can just go to here and everything logging and everything is maintained here. It says that all the information is present here, and at the end of the package it says that it is completed successfully, right? So this is something you saw it in 2008 version, right? So what I'll do is I'll compare the same thing to the 2014 version, right? What I did is I upgraded this package to 2014 version, and actually it's the same package. Whatever use the package you saw there, right, SSIS package, is the same package, but it is in 2014 version. So just see, the time taken here is something, and 2014 it will be lesser than that, right? So what I'll do is I'll stop here and I'll go back to the 2014. In the 2014, there are some changes to it. What I'll do is these are the very, very high level things what you're seeing here, and they have. If you go to the different control flow, data flow, these are the different concepts, right? Control flow is something like maintaining the flow chart, okay, to make the decision, I mean, to make the workflow. If yes, go here, if no, go here. So this is whatever you're seeing here is like control flow, which you are controlling the SSIS packages. The data flow is something like where you pull the data, right? In the control flow, what you have something like you can create a database or you can drop a database. Once it is done, you can execute a SQL script. And once it is done, you can start another bulk insert. Once it is done, you can drop the indexes. So this is the sequence of activities you do in the control flow section. But when you go to the data flow section, it is something related purely to the data and its pipeline. So from where, if you go to the data flow, right, there will be source assistant and destination assistance. In the source, it may be the source can be, if you take the source assistant, the source can be XML, flat file, CSV, DB, Oracle, my Sybase, SQL, and it can be anything, right? And target can be anything. So what I'll do is I'll try to run this package in 2014 version. So you see some changes from 2008 R2 version to the 2014 version. So if you see this package, right, the red, green, blues, the red, green, yellow symbols is converted to into a different manner. And once it is converted, it will just do the right mark, and it's very, very fast. Just see that once it starts, right, it will complete, it will finish so fast. So it is in progress, it is something showing them something like this, progress completed, right, it is completed, progress, whatever you're seeing, completed, right. That's it. So it is here it is in progress, completed, and it will come down at last here, and it says that it is also completed. So the performance of 2014 is much, much better than 2008 R2, and it is giving a lot of competition to the other player. I mean, it will give the comp, because right now it is in the evaluation version. It will be, Microsoft is waiting for a very stable version of this. So you are learning a very, very latest version. So this is started, completed, completed. So it's very fast, and it also has something like the progress thing, and we have the concepts of event handlers, parameters, which are very deep concepts, which we'll learn in the taking each example in each module of SSIS, right? This is something on SSIS. So let me take a quick question. So Piyush asked the question, how do we pull the results from the data warehouse? Once the data is loaded into the question is, how do we pull the results from the data warehouse? So the answer is, like, we can pull the data from the data warehouse using the SSIS tool, and we can prepare a cube, which is the OLAP concept, and we can generate a report, right? Some Lokesh asked, I heard Cognos reporting tools are better than SSRS. Can you explain? Lokesh, in the reporting wise, you may be right. Okay, in the Cognos is a very, very highly reliable reporting tool in the market, because they are in the market from long time. So in the SSRS, right? So in the SSRS, Microsoft improving a lot, but at the same time, Microsoft is releasing some powerful features which are not there in the Cognos. Example, if you look at the Power BI, right? Or if you look at the concept of integration of SSRS with SharePoint. So those type of things actually Cognos doesn't have. But right now in the market, if you see, Cognos is powerful tool than SSRS, but not on the jobs wise. If you take on the opportunity wise, SSRS has more jobs, right? So I think I have answered your question. Somebody else said, can we use different versions at the same time in a system? Yes, you can use. If you look at the question is, like, if we can we use different versions of MSBA at the same time in the system. If you see my system, I have lot of things here. I have right from 2005 to 8, 2008 R2, 2014, everything I have. So you can use, that's not a problem. The reports are generated on the fly or through some scheduled jobs? Very good question. So we have a concept called subscriptions in SSRS, right? So using the concept of subscriptions, a daily automatic schedule can be pushed to the email or some file location, right? And or we can see that manually also. Okay, thank you. So what I'll do is, like, I'll jump in, I mean, I'll show you something on the reporting, right? So this is the, this is how SSRS looks like. It is also a part of the Visual Studio environment, but it looks something different. What I did is, like, I was talking about the cricket scenario, right? So I was just collecting the data about the cricket and seeing what are the different types of match types we have, and how many match types were played till now. This is a real-time data for cricket. I have done a lot of work to collect this data to show the thing, but it is before 2012, right? So if you look at some of the reports using the SSRS, right? So you can generate some simple reports like this. Example, the number of matches in the IPL is almost equal to the number of tests till now, right? So the number of matches of the one day internationals, right? I'm sorry, like, if I see the color correctly, the number of tests and number of one day matches are almost same, and the IPL and T20 is almost same. So this is a representation we can get from the SSRS. So I've just shown you a very basic report, but we can generate powerful subscriptions with powerful caching mechanism and all those things in SSRS. Once we have it in the course, then we can have it in a clear picture, right? So I'm just going back to the slide. So these are the different modules we are going to cover in the course topics. So we have 10 modules totally. And what we do is, the first module is about MSBA and its overview, and the next four modules will be on SSIS, which is the ETL concept, and next couple of modules we go to the SSIS cubes, and then next couple of things we do in the reporting. And at the end of the day, as I told you, we give a project work or putting all the pieces together so that you make a final solution out of it, and we give a verifiable certificate, right? So I think I've answered most of the questions, but finally I'm just going to check if there are any other additional questions where I can answer you, right? Okay, so I think I've answered all the questions here. I hope I have not missed anyone and have not disappointed anyone. Okay. Okay, so, I missed one question from Rishi. Actually, he has left the course. I mean, he has left the webinar. So, does SSIS provide adapters for SAP mainframe, etc.? Yes, SSIS has adapters for SAP. Okay, so we can use the ODBC driver and OLED driver to pull the data from the SAP database. And for mainframes, they use a database called DB2. Okay, DB2 is the database used for mainframes and AS400 operating system. And we can connect to the DB2 using two drivers. One is OLED driver, and we can connect using the ODBC driver. Yes, we can do that. So the looking at the questions, I think I've answered all the questions of the audience. Okay. So that's it I have for today. So what you can do is, like, you can go through the whatever I explained, the indeed.com, the job trends. You can go to this link to check the trends of job, MSBA trends, right? And we collected some information from MSDN, right? So that's it I have from my side, right? So any questions, what you do is, like, you send an email to sales @edurator.co, okay? So I'll just try to put the ID as sales@edureka.co. So what the staff, the Edureka staff will reach out to you. But what you'll do, if you have any questions or concerns, just try to send an email to this so that we can try to get back to you as soon as possible. Okay, that's it from my side. Thank you for attending this session. Good night.